date it that way if I look his records up. And
yes, and
he was quite interested in it at the time I was showing him. But I can't. She'd write all the stuff down.
So did you cut it in a V when it, where it was?
Yeah, up there and left it, and it sort of cut around the roots of it.
Left it?
And left it, and then it's always been here and there. It's been over in Helen's Bay and sort of lifted up and bring it back and forth, you know.
Right.
It just needs a hell of a lot of work. You see, all this needs, you know, some of it's overgrown, you know, and just needs some clipping back. And, you know, I need to spend like a couple of days, you know, nice. Hours and hours on that.
On that, yeah.
Refining all those little things in there. Wouldn't be long until that was, you know, that was wide enough to, it'll never be, never going to be able to let it go tall enough for that.
Yeah.
That's too much, really, you know that. And it just obviously self-seeded it. It's a witch elm, and it was growing out across staff flats. Mm-hmm. And the groundsman must have just cut it off over, you know, a period of sort of 10, 15 years or so.
Mm-hmm.
I probably think it was since the 60s or the 50s. I was up in the wall and I took it out. And it was actually like that. So
right.
I picked that up and turned it, and that was sort of growing. The branches were growing out.
Yeah.
And then so I sort of set it
down
horizontal
to make it wrap.
And then just screwed up. See how it's been cut a lot, you know. But get quite a lot of dieback on that. That's the only thing you see. I saw dieback coming on that. You know, but
oh,
see,
yeah,
it seems to come back. Okay. They've all got good roots, you know, because I've grown them all from seed.
So you're able to pick and choose?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But with that beach there, it's amazing. I had to lift that every year, and every year the sort of roots seem to sort of go out of shape a wee bit, you know.
Have you ever twisted and turned? Sort of, yeah.
Best angle of it.
How often would you lift them out of the ground to do that sort of work?
I haven't lifted them enough. I mean, I think they've probably been in for 6 years since although the beach aren't too bad, they're not too, they don't go too deeply. But I'm just going to have to cut the roots back in.
And those are all from seed?
Yeah, as far as I remember. Yeah, they must be. What age is it? 15 years old now, maybe. Those are just more or less natural twists and turns on it. I think that's probably
over that side. Side. Yeah.
It's hard to make it out. There's that many leaves in the ground, the same colour.
Yeah.
So long's that one been in the ground?
Again, since we've moved in here, I suppose, from 6 years now. 2004.
You think the other side's the front?
Yeah, I think so. Hold on. I need to get it out, really, and look at it, think about it for a while. Any, and it's sort of like a bit of a Y shape, and from this side it is, but if you look at it from the other side, it yeah, it looks so much better. Daisy, come out of it. Daisy, come over, you know, but it was just too thick here. I gotta cut it back again, so yes. Eventually it'll. Oh yeah, it's a little bit. I don't know why it's sort of gone thick here. It's a bit sort of inverse taper, isn't it?
Yeah, see that.
Yeah, that's pretty solid in there, you know.
It's
going all the way down again, so we'll have to cut that back. So.
That was the one somebody had.
Yeah, somebody gave it.
Somebody gave it to you. Yeah. One of the ballot prize or something at the club, and
it's very sort of awkward looking shape. I can't actually remember what shape it was originally, but I think it must have been a big branch coming out this way. Over a fireplace, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And then I just sawed right across there, and I just carved that just those two chisels there. And it turned out well. Trouble is it cracks a lot, so you've got a cracking on it.
And you've never done this before?
No, I've never done any carving really at all. But I thought I would just have a go, and I really enjoyed it. It's just